one of you mathematicians to get ready after that. Listen to this so you'll know if anybody is not eligible to run for this office, then we'll give you time to remove yourself. A bishop shall be constituted by the election of an elder by two-thirds of all the members of the General Conference present and voting at the session duly called. Laying on of hands of three or more bishops, or at least one bishop and two elders. Somebody's doing the math, right? Bishop is consecrated for life, or so long as his or her spirit and practice are such as become the gospel. If a bishop ceases from traveling at large among the people without the consent of the General Conference, he or she cannot be allowed in any degree to exercise his or her episcopal office. Or by infirmity or otherwise, if she becomes incompetent to perform his or her duties, he or she shall be retired. Jump down to 241. 48th session of the General Conference directs that any elder is eligible to be elected to the office of bishop who has been traveling ministers in the AV Zion Church for 20 years. Don't finish, you have time to get out. If you're not 40 years of age, if you have more than one living spouse, meaning a former spouse and present spouse cannot be alive. With an earned advanced degree in theological training from an accredited institution of learning, was not been expelled from the 89 Church or any other communion or denomination. Now, you don't fit the criteria that's enumerated. All right. We have three nuts who will come and give us some instructions regarding the keypad and how to use them. What's going to be before us? We have Sabrina here. She's here. All right. Please be attentive.
Good evening. Okay, all of the voting delegates should have a keypad at your table. Your keypad should already be powered on.
And ready to use.
Does everyone have their keypad? Okay, so to use this keypad, when you're voting on one option, all you need to do is press the number that corresponds with your answer choice, followed by the send key. So just the number and then send. Okay? Now the system will only take your last vote. So if you press 1 send and you meant to press 2, simply press 2 send and the system will take number 2. So let's try a practice question. Is this your first?
one for yes and
two for no.
You would press number one for yes and number two for no, and then send. Does everybody understand that? Okay, so go ahead and vote now, one for yes or two for no, and then send. Again, if you change your mind, you can simply re-vote.
I'm pushing three.
Okay, 16.
Oh, okay.
Ain't nothing on it.